Hello dear students, how are you? I hope you are fine. This is Bhavika, your chemistry mentor, welcoming you to the amazing platform of PW English. So today we are going to learn about chemical equation and reaction. Yes, it may sound very complex, but it is very easy. I make sure that after your lecture, your concepts, your basics of chemical equation and reaction will become crystal clear. So, let us get started. So, first of all, what is chemical equation? Right? Chemical equations are what? They are symbolic representation. They are symbolic representation of chemical reaction in which, okay, it is a symbolic representation like a shortcut, okay, it is the shortest way, it is the shortest way to denote a chemical reaction, shortest way. How? Because why the shortest way? Because while writing chemical equation, we use their symbols, okay, we use their chemical formula. Okay, our last lecture was of how to write chemical formula, and that chemical formula we are going to use while writing chemical equations. Okay, in which the reactant and the product are expressed in term of their respective chemical formula. Okay, I will teach you all that what are reactants, what are products. Okay, but for now you just learn, you just understand that chemical equation, it is the shortest form. It is the shortest form of a chemical reaction. Chemical equations make use of symbols, right? They make use of symbols to represent factors such as the direction of the reaction and the physical states of reactant entities. Sorry. What information does it give to us? It gives the information of its physical entities. It gives the information of the direction of reaction. Whether the reaction is going in forward direction or whether the reaction is going in reverse direction. Okay, I will tell you what is forward and reverse. Okay. So, chemical reactions can be represented on a paper with the help of chemical equations represented below. Okay, so this is the very easiest, very easy to understand equation. See what we have to do. Instead of writing hydrogen, see, this is basically hydrogen reacting with oxygen and it is giving you water. If I have to say this equation in terms of a statement, what would I say? That when hydrogen reacts with oxygen, it gives water. Such a long statement, right? I have to say this again and again. It becomes very lengthy, right? It becomes very lengthy, lethargic to say this statement every now and then. So, what I can do? I could write as like hydrogen plus oxygen gives water. This plus indicates that there are more than one reactant present. It is the combination of two or more reactants giving just one product, right? Or again short, you will say, no ma'am, we want again a shorter way. So what I did, instead of hydrogen I wrote H2, instead of oxygen I wrote O2, and instead of water I wrote 2. Okay, now there can be no shorter way than this, and this is your chemical equation. Okay, So this is your chemical equation. Okay. The entities, okay, this H2 and O2, which is on the left side, which is on the left side of arrow, they are known as reactants. What they are known as? Reactants, because they are reacting with each other and giving you a product. Okay. So, this both are reactants. एंड ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड इट इज प्रोडक्ट. ओके, सो द रिएक्शन रिएक्शन इज गोइंग फ्रॉम रिएक्टेंट टू प्रोडक्ट. सो दिस इज विच डिरेक्शन? दिस इज फॉरवर्ड डिरेक्शन. इट इज गोइंग फ्रॉम रिएक्टेंट टू प्रोडक्ट. इफ द रिएक्शन इज कमिंग फ्रॉम प्रोडक्ट टू रिएक्टेंट, विच मीन्स प्रोडक्ट बिकम्स रिएक्टेंट एंड रिएक्टेंट बिकम प्रोडक्ट. इफ द रिएक्शन इज गोइंग इन दिस डिरेक्शन, सो दिस बिकम योर विच डिरेक्शन? रिवर्स डिरेक्शन. ओके, एंड दिस इज योर फॉरवर्ड डिरेक्शन. ओके, सो दिस इज द थिंग. इट कैन बी ऑब्जर्व इन द एग्जाम्पल प्रोवाइडेड अबव दैट द रिएक्टिंग एंटिटीज आर रिटन ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड, वेयर द प्रोडक्ट्स दैट आर फॉर्म्ड फॉर द केमिकल रिएक्शन आर रिटन ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड. ऑलवेज रिमेंबर दैट रिएक्टेंट्स विल बी ऑन द ओके. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट फॉरवर्ड ऑफ कोर्स. I'm talking about forward direction, of course, that reactants will be always on the left side of the arrow and product will be always on the right hand side of the arrow. Okay, that is the thing. See, these are the reactants, also known as substrate. Yes, and this is your product. Okay, you may ask then, ma'am, what is this two, this two? These two are coefficients returned to balance the chemical equation. Okay, in 10th standard, in the chapter number 1, the name chapter names is also chemical reaction and equation, in which you will learn about balancing. Okay, balancing is done to just equate the mass on the both side. Okay, you must have learned the law of conservation of mass in standard 9th, which says that mass can never be created nor can be destroyed. Okay, so the mass should be conserved. So the mass of reactants, okay, so the mass of reactants should be equal to mass of product. Okay, both should be equal, and in order to make it equal, we are keeping this two, so that the number of atoms on the both the side gets equal, and if the atoms are equal, then the mass is automatically equal. Clear till here? So these are reactants, these are products, this is the arrow. Okay, you must see this. This is G is written here, G is written here, also G is. What does this suggest? Okay, this suggests the physical state. Okay, the physical state of these entities, right? Here H2 is in gas form, so that's why G is written. Oxygen is also in gas form, that's why G is written. And the water you are getting is also in a G, that is in vapor form, that's why G. For solid, okay, for solid you will write S in the bracket, for liquid you will write L in the bracket, for gas you will write G, and for aqueous solution, for aqueous solution what you will write? You will write AQ. What is AQ? What is aqueous, ma'am? Solid, liquid, gas is okay, but what is aqueous? See, if you are dissolving your something, you're dissolving your matter, you're dissolving your solution in water, okay, you're making your solution in water, then that state become aqueous solution. Okay, aqueous means that particular thing is made in water. Okay, that particular solution is made in water, so that becomes your aqueous solution, just like liquid. Okay, but here liquid means liquid could be any liquid, but if I talk about aqueous, then that particular solution is compulsorily made in water. Okay, so from equation you can also know their physical state, right? So much informative. Okay, now let us talk about chemical reaction. I hope you must have understood. You must have understood about what is chemical equation. Okay, it is the shortest form of writing a chemical equation. It consists of symbols, right? It consists of different symbols. It consists of chemical formulas. It consists of reactants on the left hand side and products on the right hand side with a arrow in between. Okay, it also has what? It also has physical quantities assigned with them. So that what we studied about chemical equation. Now we are going to talk about chemical reaction. What is chemical reaction? A process in which, okay, chemical reaction is a process in which one or more substance, the reactants, are converted to one or more different substances, that is products. Like it is a conversion. What is chemical reaction? It is a chemical process that converts reactant into product. Okay, the process called a chemical process. Okay, where you may say that the entire the chemical form of reactants is changed. Okay, their properties are changed, their physical chemical both properties are changed. Substance are either chemical elements or compounds. Okay, they could also be elements, they could be compounds. Okay, they could be anything. A chemical reaction rearranges the constituent atoms of the reactant to create different substances as products. So, what they are trying to tell, that reactants rearrange themselves. Okay. Reactants rearrange themselves to give a specific products. Okay. So, that is what a chemical reaction is. Okay, now these are the type of chemical reaction. You are going to study it in detail in 10th standard. But right now I am giving a just a rough idea about it. Okay, that what are chemical reactions. See, this type of chemical reaction is known as combination or synthesis reaction. Okay, this is your combination reaction. What happens in it? That two elements compound or element or compound, any two substance get combined to each other and give one product. So here reactants could be two or more than two. Okay, here the reactants could be two or more than two, but your product will be necessary only one. Yes. Why? Because the reactants are combining and the product is one. That's why this reaction is a combination reaction. Okay, which type of reaction it is? Combination. Okay, next is decomposition. Okay, this is decomposition, exactly opposite of combination. Their combination was happening, here breakdown is happening. So here there will be always one reactant and the product could be two or more than two. Okay, here product was one, here reactant is one. One reactant is breaking down. Okay, the breakdown can be done in the presence of heat also, in the presence of electricity, or in the presence of sunlight. Okay, there are three modes to break down it. Okay, so it could be broken down into two or more products. Okay, clear till here? Yes. Next is single displacement reaction. It is like hera fer. The more reactive metal is displacing less reactive metal from its position. You can think as, okay, what you can think? You can think that red is more powerful. Okay. What you can think? That red is more powerful and blue ball is less powerful. So what is happening? This more powerful just kick out this blue one and takes it position. So it comes out like this. Okay. So the more powerful one kicking out the less powerful one and taking its place. Okay. And taking its place. And this type of reaction is known as displacement reaction. Okay. Just displacing it. Replacing it. Okay. You can say like that also. So this is your single displacement. And last is double displacement. It is just like adla badli, exchange. Okay, you will just see here exchange of ions taking place. See, here with red ball, green ball is there. in here with pink, blue is there. But after double displacement, what you will see? With red, what came? With red, blue became bond. And with green, pink came. Okay, so this is double displacement. This is single displacement. That was single displacement. This is double displacement. Okay, exchange of ions takes place. So, these were the major types of chemical reaction. Yes, first one was combination, where two or more element or compound just combine to give one product. Decomposition means where one reactant break down into numerous products. Yes. Third one is where more reactive metal displaces less reactive metal. And fourth is double displacement, where exchange of ions takes place. Okay, so this were the types of chemical reaction, majorly types of reaction. Okay, so this was all about chemical equation and reaction. I hope you have understood this topic well. Okay, this was just a gist of it. You are going to learn this chapter in detail in 10th standard. The chapter 1 is of this only. So I hope it makes a bridge for you and you don't feel like you are learning something new. Okay, so just take care of yourself, keep smiling, and see you in the next class. Thank you.